The total small business recovery fund, according to government, was earmarked at 200 billion shillings, with a government remitting half, and participating commercial banks would raise the extra 100 billion. Whereas the fund was meant to ease pressure from millions of businesses that were recovering from effects of COVID-19, Traders Association Kasita chairman laments about the continuous frustrations.
Banks have been auctioning their property. We have had several engagements with the banks, try to be flexible, which is yielding some positive results. For example, currently now the bank can allow you to look for another possible buyer so that you pay the bank and remain with something than the bank totally auctioning your property. I think that's a very good measure, at least the bank which they have adopted, and even giving you some more time to look for other sources where you can meet your obligation. But it hasn't been so easy. Furthermore, we had had several challenges with our members meeting their tax obligation. For example, there is a flexible strategy which the government adopted by trying to forego the penalties.
Thaddeus Musoke says government should rethink the program. While wrapping the highlights of 2023, he noted that it was a mixed bag, with some businesses doing fairly well while others struggled with effects of COVID-19.
So they avail to us loans with high interest, and by the this one has negatively affected the recovery process, because with the recovery fund they could give you that fund. If you have a loan earlier with a bank, like if the bank is demanding you 10 million, I can access 50 million. I pay the 10 million to the bank, I remain with the 40 million to recapitalize. And then my business will try to recover. And then they give you a duration of 1 year. And before you're starting to pay, then after that year, you start meeting your obligation.
Meanwhile, Kampala City Traders Association has commended URA for its commitment to sensitize traders about the relevance of paying taxes promptly. Story by Benin Ojambo for the news.